After Blenheim by Robert Southey. Robert Southey was an English romantic poet. He was the poet laureate, court poet of his time. He wrote this poem in 1796 about a battle that took place in Blenheim, a village in southern Germany, in 1704. It is an anti-war poem that sharply criticizes the destruction and death caused by war. The poet uses the simple narrative of a grandfather explaining to his two grandchildren his own suffering and the suffering of many others like him who were victims of the battle. The grandfather cannot give any good reason for war and can only repeat that it was a famous victory. Obviously, this was the propaganda that was indoctrinated in the common people. The poet wants to emphasize through the repetition of the lines that wars are senseless, futile and evil, and that in war there are no real winners. This is a powerful poem that echoes Wilfred Owen's famous quote, "The Pity of War." This poem is a wake-up call to seek peaceful solution to all conflicts. After Blenheim by Robert Southey. It was a summer evening. Old Caspar's work was done, and he, before his cottage door, was sitting in the sun. And by him sported on the green his little grandchild Wilhelmine. She saw her brother Peterkin roll something large and round, which he beside the rivulet in playing there had found. He came to ask what he had found that was so large and smooth and round. Old Caspar took it from the boy, who stood expectant by, and then the old man shook his head, and with a natural sigh, "Is some poor fellow's skull," said he, "who fell in the great victory. I find them in the garden, for there's many here about, and often when I go to plough, the ploughshare turns them out." "For many thousand men," said he, "were slain in that great victory. Now tell us what it was all about." "Young Peterkin," he cries, and little Wilhelmine looks up with wonder-waiting eyes. "Now tell us all about the war, and what they fought each other for." "It was the English," Caspar cried, "who put the French to rout. But what they fought each other for, I could not well make out. But everybody said," quoth he, "that it was a famous victory. My father lived at Blenheim then, yon little stream hard by. They burnt his dwelling to the ground, and he was forced to fly. So with his wife and child he fled, nor had he where to rest his head. With fire and sword the country round was wasted far and wide, and many a childing mother then and newborn baby died. But things like that, you know, must be at every famous victory. They say it was a shocking sight after the field was won, for many thousand bodies here lay rotting in the sun. But things like that, you know, must be after a famous victory. Great praise the Duke of Marlborough won, and our good Prince Eugene. Why, it was a very wicked thing," said little Wilhelmine. "Nay, nay, my little girl," quoth he, "it was a famous victory. and everybody praised the Duke, who this great fight did win. But what good came of it at last? Quoth little Peterkin. Why, that I cannot tell, said he, but it was a famous victory.